Hi everyone, and welcome back. I bet it is for you TV. We had a fantastic week with the Champions League and Europa League, and now football is once again back as we have a packed weekend. And in this show, we're going to focus on Saturday betting opportunities. We will provide you with a double and a mega accumulator released by our expert here at Betting is for You TV at Quarter. So the double, you know what it is. The mega accumulator, if you haven't seen it last weekend show, last Saturday show, it is a six-fold ACCA where our experts are trying to eat very long odds. Last weekend, we went very, very close. If you backed that bet with us, you would probably know. We had four selection out of six correct. And during the evening, we were very close to get the fifth one as well, as we had Brighton and draw against Leicester, and Brighton lost in the last minute. So we're going again this week, this Saturday. So if you love betting on a Saturday accumulator, that's exactly what you want to go for. Otherwise, if you're looking for shorter odds, we also have plenty of opportunities. As after the double, we're also going to our Premier League expert, Robbie Billund. They will give us the tips on the Premier League. And last but not least, we are going to Italy, where our local expert, Luca Semproni, will provide us tips for Saturday Serie A and La Liga. So if you followed the previous show, the Europa League show, for example, you could see that we won the Tottenham bet, in the bet of the day, as we backed Tottenham to win with one goal handicap against Dinamo Zagreb. And we went very, very close to win a massive 8-1 fourfold. The only selection that let us down was the over 2.5 in Manchester United against Milan. I mean, if you have watched that game, you will know that that was all over. That the over was all over that game, as basically Maguire missed an opportunity that I still don't understand how it's possible that they missed the opportunity. And then we also had a goal disallowed for Milan. So, you know, that was very, very close. And unfortunately, he ended with the under. So we didn't win that bet, but we went very close. So we go in again. And, you know, we are quite pleased to get even that close, even if unfortunately we didn't win in that occasion. Make sure you subscribe to Betting is for You TV, as you will be able to access all those exclusive tips and also get notifications when new videos are released. Remember that those tips are not available on our website or on our Twitter feed. You can only find them by watching videos here at Betting is for You TV on YouTube. All you need to do to subscribe is to log in into your YouTube account, click in the link in the post above, and everything is completely free. Also, in the description below, you will find the links that will load the best suggestion in this video directly in your bet slip. In this way, you will save time, as you don't have to find those selections in the bookmaker sites. You will ensure to back our tips correctly and also get the best possible odds, as we always look for the bookmakers that have the best price for our tips. Remember though that odds are always subject to change, so make sure you double check them before betting. But now let's start with the double for Saturday. So the first match that we want to focus on is Portsmouth against Salford, which is the final of the EFL trophy of last year. Yes, because last year, for obvious reasons, it didn't happen. So more than a year after, the respective semi-final wins over Exeter and Newport, those two teams are clashing at Wembley. It will be interesting if Portsmouth will be able to retain the trophy for just one day, because actually on Sunday then there is this season finale that will also take place. So yeah, strange situation at the moment, but this is a final and surely Portsmouth will want to win this trophy. Both clubs come into this match in a dreadful form. They've been really, really bad in their respective leagues, and they will probably hope to get a win so they can get some momentum to just kickstart again their promotion push. Portsmouth are coming to this match having taken 1 point from the last four games, and they are starting to look very nervously behind their shoulders, as the other teams are actually chasing very closely for their playoff places. Salford, also, they are not in better shape. They have taken 6 points from the last six games. And again, it looks like their promotion push is actually faltering in League Two. Having said that, Portsmouth have better qualities. They are a league above, and we believe that on Saturday they will be able to edge this match. So, begging Portsmouth to win against Salford look the best bet in this case. So it's the first selection of our double. The second selection of our double is coming from the evening match on the Premier League, which is Manchester City and Fulham. We are begging Fulham to have over 3.5 corners. So obviously it will be very difficult to understand or to actually predict what is going to be Pep Guardiola lineup today on Sunday, on Saturday, as they're coming from a midweek game in the Premier League against Southampton, and also they have a Champions League match coming up on Tuesday. So he will definitely do a rotation. After all, they got now nearly every player available. But it is very difficult to understand, to predict what will be the final squad for Saturday. Looking at City's performance, we could be that they've been you know, fantastic all year round. But we're starting to see some defensive cracks coming up. And if we look at the stats, we can see that they haven't been able to keep a clean sheet in the last four games. And against Southampton in midweek, they've been quite lucky to concede only twice. So I think Fulham have an opportunity here. They're coming here in good spirit. They had very good results recently. And they're coming from having defeated the champions, the current champions, Liverpool. So they are in good confidence. They are playing much better than they were at the beginning of the season. And definitely they should be able to cause opportunity, to create opportunities, especially in counter-attack. So they have been very effective when playing against big side this season. And if you look at corners number, they had 4+ corner in both matches against Liverpool, 5+ against Leicester, and also managed 3 away to City early this season. So definitely there is value in backing them to have over 3.5 corner. And even though City doesn't generally concede too many corners, recently this number are starting to rise, and if we expect, you know, there will also be some rotation and some changes in Pep Guardiola's team, you can expect that you know they probably concede more opportunities. So this is a very good second option for us, and this double return 4-1, which means if you bet £10 you will get back around 53, which is very nice if you're looking for a medium double to get some to get your Saturday kick started. So the second bet of Saturday from our expert here, Bet This For You TV, is the Mega Accumulator. It's a sixfold ACCA, and we're starting with the first match, which is with the first selection, which is draw Burnley double chance against Everton. So we're backing Burnley not to lose. So if there is a draw or Burnley win, we win the bet. And obviously, you know, this could raise some eyebrows. I mean, you might not understand this bet, but let me present you some of our facts, because Burnley have lost just one of the last 7 games in the Premier League. And also, the only side, the sides that have been able to beat Burnley since the start of October, if we do exclude Leeds, have been all those teams that are in contention for a Champions League spot. So we had Spurs, they lost against Spurs, Chelsea, Manchester City, Manchester United and West Ham. So definitely they are a team that is difficult to beat. And Everton, in addition to that, when they need to win games, they generally don't win them. And if we don't see them really as, I mean, they have had a good season, but they've been too inconsistent. And if they want to really be a force in the Premier League, they need to find more consistency. And at the moment, they don't have it. So the match against Burnley looked for us the typical match where the Toffees are likely to struggle. And although we're not going to say that Burnley is going to win this match, but we believe there is value to back that they will not lose. The second selection of our sixfold is both teams to score in Birmingham against Bristol City. Both those two teams have been going through very, very difficult periods. If we look at the hosts, we can see that they're sitting just 3 points above the drop zone in the championship. And they are nervously looking after behind their shoulders, because there are teams like Rotterdam, for example, that have 3 games in hand over them. So Aitor Karanka's side absolutely will be nervous going to this match. And although they have opportunities, because they take on a Bristol City side who have lost 9 of the last 11 in all competitions, And even though the arrival Nigel Pearson looked at for a while to have improved the situation, things have reversed once again, and they were disappointingly defeated by QPR in the last weekend. If we also look at this, some other stats, we can see that 53% of Birmingham home matches have featured both sides to score in this term, and also that Bristol have scored 3 goals against Swansea and Middlesbrough in the last 2 away from home. So definitely there are 2 teams that are inconsistent. They do score goals, but they concede a lot because they have, you know, very vulnerable defences. So we expect this to be an open and nervy affair where goals should come from both ends. And this is our second selection of our mega accumulator. Thus, for the third selection of our mega accumulator is the over 2.5 in Charlton v Shrewsbury. So the home side is at the moment sitting a point outside the playoff in League One. And the Addicts will definitely, in our opinion, probably win this match. But it's not going to be a one-way affair. If we look at Charlton's last matches, especially if we look at Charlton's last 7 home games, we can see that the over 2.5 was always the outcome. And the reason is that although they do score goals, their defence has been far than solid, especially when playing in front of, well, not in front of their fans at the moment, but in their own stadium. And I've conceded at least 2 or more goals in 9 of the last 10 games at the Valley. So definitely an opportunity for Shrewsbury to cause them problems. They are coming into this match 9 points above the drop zone in 17th place. But on the road, they've done considerably better, much better than at home. And in fact, if we look at their stats, we can see that 6 of their 10 wins have come away from home, including some impressive 1-0 victories against promotion hopefuls Hull, Lincoln and Doncaster. So definitely the Chefs can cause Charlton problems, and also they are coming in good spirit after winning last time at Rochdale, and they also have been netting in all of their last 4 away matches. So we do expect this to be an open affair. Goals should be there, and the over 2.5 looks an obvious bet for us. The fourth selection is Watford to beat Cardiff. So both teams are coming into this match in great form. This is probably going to be one of the most interesting matches of the Championship this Saturday. Cardiff have had a massive surge since the arrival of Mick McCarthy. They are actually now you know, in contention for a playoffs position. But they're coming into this weekend this weekend they're going to have what is probably their biggest test so far since the arrival of the new manager, as Watford has been impressive since the arrival of Six Communions at Vicarage Road. And if we look at the stats, only Norwich has been able to make more points than the Hornets, who have won 6 of the last 7 matches. So basically, we believe that despite they've made a massive improvement in recent weeks with Mick McCarthy, this is not going to be enough to stop a Watford side that are flying at the moment. So we're begging Watford to win against Cardiff. The fifth selection of our six-fold accumulator is Barnsley draw against Bournemouth. So the Tykes have been a great story in the Championship recently. They've been in great form, and they moved from a mediocre, like an average mid-table position, to be a very strong playoff candidate. So Barnsley are coming into this match unbeaten in the last 10 matches in the league, and they surely have an opportunity here, as Bournemouth have only won 4 of the 9 matches under Jonathan Woodgate since the arrival of the new manager. In addition to that, Barnsley haven't lost a league game since the 1-0 defeat at Watford in mid-January, and also are unbeaten in the last 4 away from home with 3 wins. So definitely we do expect Barnsley at least to avoid a defeat, and obviously if we would bet this as a single, we'd probably go for Barnsley to win. But considering we're doing a 6-fold, we're quite happy with Barnsley draw, because I mean they drew, for example, last weekend, and it could happen that they do it again, as Bournemouth, you know, are a quality side. So Barnsley draw, double chances, our fifth selection. And the last selection is again a double chance. We're going for draw Udinese in Genova against Udinese. So this is the last match. It's a Serie A match. It takes place on Saturday night. So let's hope that by that time we still our bet is still alive, because then we will all really keen to see this game. And if we're looking at the two teams, I mean, Udinese are coming in great form. They are unbeaten in the last four matches in Serie A with two wins and two draws. Le Zebrette are also unbeaten in the last nine meetings against Genoa with six wins. So they have a good tradition in this fixture. And Genoa, I mean, they have a very good period under David Ballardini when the new manager came a few weeks ago. But things have started to take a turn to the worse for them. And they are now without a victory in the last five league games with two defeats. So they are down in 13th place, and they are 5 points behind Udinese at the moment. So we do expect that it's difficult to see the host win in this match against such a good Udinese side at the moment. Although Genoa are undefeated, unbeaten in seven at home at the Stadio Luigi Ferraris, with four draws in the last two matches. So we think that, again, similar to the, what we said to for the Barnsley game, that backing Udinese to win would be too risky. So we are doing with the double chance to cover that the draw as well. So that concludes our six-fold. We have, therefore, a six-fold. The return is 37-1 at the moment. So if you bet £10, you get back 370 if everything goes to plan. And let's hope that everything will go to plan. So that concludes the bets provided here, but from our expert here, Betting for You TV at quarter. We are now ready to speak with Robbie Billund, our Premier League expert, that is ready with us. So, Robin, that's over to you.
Hi, everyone. It's Saturday, and it's time for more football. And, of course, it's Premier League football that we are digging into and looking into some of the great games we have ahead of us today. Of course, kicking off the Saturday in style with Leeds against Chelsea here at the lunch game. But we have picked our bets, a combination, and our best bet of the day from the games later on today. So we give you some more time to take your own look and make your own opinions about it. We start out with Crystal Palace against West Bromwich. It's a Crystal Palace team that have only scored 3 goals in their last 5 games, up against the West Bromwich side who have only scored 2 goals in their last 5 games. So it's two teams that have huge problems when it comes to their goal scoring. And two managers, maybe not most famous for their attacking football. It's Roy Hodgson against Sam Allardyce. And we think this is a clear-cut under 2.5 goals game. So that's the start for Saturday. And we are combining that with a pick from Everton against Burnley. Everton, of course, they lost against Chelsea, but that is a good Chelsea side. We have learned that under Thomas Tuchel. But before Chelsea, Everton had 3 consecutive wins. They won at Anfield 2-0. And then back-to-back wins against Southampton and Sheffield United, 1-0 each in those games. And this could probably be something like that. They are hosting Burnley, a team we also know struggles with their goal scoring. And Everton, they look solid, they look very Carlo Ancelotti built, and should be able to control this game, and they should also be able to find a way to win it. But we stick to the under 2.5 line here as well, instead of looking who is the winner. So our Saturday combination, the double for Saturday, that is under 2.5 goals in both games, Crystal Palace against West Bromwich and also Everton against Burnley. The best bet for Saturday is from Fulham against Manchester City, the evening game from Saturday's Premier League fixtures. And it's at Craven Cottage in London, and Fulham are the hosts to Manchester City. I think we all know that Manchester City, they will be the winners of this Premier League title. And they have looked so solid. They were on the crazy 21 run winning streak until they lost the derby last weekend. They have conceded actually back to back two goals in both the derby and also against Southampton, even though they won 5-2. Fulham, they have looked very solid as well. They took, of course, for them, huge win in terms of when they traveled to Anfield, won 1-0 against Liverpool. And we should not underestimate what Scott Parker is building at Fulham. And they are now in contention to actually secure a place within the Premier League for next season as well. But with a Manchester City side that conceded back-to-back two goals each and also actually four games in a row without a clean sheet, I think that Pep Guardiola is focusing on now getting that clean sheet. They are going into the Champions League again with a return leg against Mönchengladbach in the week that comes. And of course, they're hoping to go to the quarters, the semis. They want to go all the way in the Champions League and they need to rebuild that solid, structured defense. So I think City will keep a clean sheet and I think somehow they will also find a way to win it. So the best bet for Saturday, that is Manchester City winning 2-0 against Fulham. And I hope you are finding some value in those tips as well. And good luck for everyone and have a great weekend.
Thank you very much, Robin. And let's hope that we can win more Premier League bets this weekend. Robin has been great, and generally all our experts have been very, very prolific in terms of winning bets in the last few weeks. And here at Bet This For You TV at Quarter, we back all the tips from our experts because we know how much effort they put into it, how much analysis, and also their great experience. So we trust them, and we've done well in trusting them as we won plenty of bets. You can watch all the previous episodes to find out all the winning bets. Or you can navigate to our website, bettingisforyou.com, and go to the section bettingisforyou TV, where you will find some of the latest episodes and also winning bets. But now let's go over to Italy as our local Italian and Spanish expert, Luca Semproni, the king of goal scorer tips, as we call it, is ready now to give some more tips for this Saturday from the Serie A and the Liga. Luca, I can see that you're ready, so that's over to you.
Ciao Simone, come al solito un saluto a tutti gli appassionati che ci seguono su Betting Tips For You. Oggi vogliamo consigliarvi una doppia per quanto riguarda il campionato italiano e, come al solito, una scommessa singola su un marcatore. Partiamo dalla doppia. La prima scommessa che vogliamo fare è Benevento-Fiorentina 1. È vero, il Benevento non sta attraversando un buon momento perché comunque viene nelle ultime 5 partite da 3 pareggi e 2 sconfitte. Nell'ultima partita ha pareggiato 1-1 con lo Spezia. Però la squadra di Inzaghi comunque rimane una buona squadra che pratica un buon calcio, un calcio comunque anche aggressivo. E perché vogliamo giocare l'1? Perché ecco, gioca contro la Fiorentina, anch'essa nelle ultime 5 un pareggio, 3 sconfitte e una vittoria. Nell'ultima partita 3-3 con il Parma, addirittura acciuffato al 94esimo. Come abbiamo detto altre volte, Prandelli comunque non ha prodotto quel risultato che si sperava quando è stato cambiato allenatore. Quindi, essendo poi tra l'altro una giocata alta, Benevento-Fiorentina, vogliamo giocare l'1. La seconda scommessa che vogliamo fare è Sassuolo-Verona, over 2,5. Il Sassuolo ha ottenuto nelle ultime 5 partite 2 pareggi, una vittoria e ha subito 2 sconfitte. Viene dal 2-0 con l'Udinese, dove ha giocato male e ha perso nettamente, anche se comunque l'Udinese è veramente in un buon periodo e in buona forma. Il Verona invece una sconfitta, 2 vittorie e 2 pareggi nelle ultime 5, ha perso in casa con il Milan 2-0 nell'ultima partita, non è stato mai in gioco, comunque ha giocato male, sconfitta meritata con un Milan tra l'altro in bottiglia di riserve. Però anche qui abbiamo detto altre volte, complimenti a Juric e alla sua squadra che stanno facendo un grande campionato. una bella partita tra due squadre che giocano bene, che segnano. Quindi Sassuolo-Verona over 2,5. Quindi ricapitolando, la doppia è Benevento-Fiorentina 1, Sassuolo-Verona over 2,5. Passiamo al marcatore, scommessa singola. Vogliamo scommettere su Caputo, marcatore in Sassuolo-Verona. È un giocatore che già vi abbiamo consigliato altre volte, perché? Perché comunque è un giocatore, una punta che segna spesso, soprattutto le partite in casa. Quest'anno 11 gol, lo scorso anno 21 gol. Quindi marcatore Caputo in Sassuolo-Verona. Nel ricordarvi, come al solito, di giocare responsabilmente, auguro buon calcio a tutti e ridò a te la linea, Simone.
Thank you very much, Luca, and let's hope that you can keep up that reputation of being a great goalscorer tipster, and we can win more bets from the Serie A and La Liga this weekend and this Saturday especially. So that concludes our show. We're gonna have another show on Sunday. So if you're looking for more bets on Sunday, just make sure you subscribe to BetThisForYou TV. You will get notification when the Sunday video is ready with the new tips. But for the time being, I wish you great day with football. Good luck with your bets. Most importantly, though, always remember to gamble responsibly. Make sure you subscribe to BetThisForYou TV, as you will be able to access all those exclusive tips and also get notifications when new videos are released. Remember that those tips are not available on our website or on our Twitter feed. You can only find them by watching videos here at BetThisForYou TV on YouTube. All you need to do to subscribe is to log in into your YouTube account, click in the link in the post above, and everything is completely free. Also, in the description below, you will find the links that will load the bet suggested in this video directly in your bet slip. In this way, you will save time, as you don't have to find those selections in the bookmaker sites. You will ensure to back our tips correctly and also get the best possible odds, as we always look for the bookmakers that have the best price for our tips. Remember, though, that odds are always subject to change, so make sure you double check them before betting.